Hi, my name is Ralitsa Dimitrova, and I'm a cancer survivor, but not from NET. My mother was diagnosed 2009, and thanks to Novartis, I had the possibility to have a connection with cancer patients with neuroendocrine tumor. And since 2009, we are supporting patients with information, because here we have 350,000 cancer patients who are treated, and the problem was lack of information and long lead time to the treatment, and a very low survival rate. Half of the patients who are contacted us are young people in an active age, and still the stigma and discrimination at work is very high. And the problem is that the system is not patient-centric. It is like a stepmother for the patients. And what I'm doing with the patients, I'm helping them to go through the system. How we do this? They share with us the information, and we narrow them to the specific pathologies. She's having a very big interest about the diagnosis and about the markers. And she is our like a second opinion. And then we are preferably working with three oncology centers that doctors are trying personally to engage with the patients. The most important for me through these years, this is a lesson that I've learned, and how to teach the patients to ask for emotional engagement with the doctor. Because they're treated like a bed, like a number, they're receiving their treatment. And this is very sad, especially when the patient is footballized around the country for the different examinations. And at the beginning, there was very difficult about the octrooscan scan. And what we do, we support patients to go out of the country to receive second opinion. And because of the physical capacity that we have, we are a very small number of people. Even my family members are included in. We support them to go to Uppsala or Charité. The biggest problem for us is that the waiting time is too high, and lack of information. It's not enough only through our green line and psychology support. It's not working very well because the patients are not having here an organization, and they're coming through this psychologist 2-3 times and then disappear. And the second is the long lead time, and we want to create a new type of consultation with young students, medical students, who are having personal engagement with these people, and these people should be trained. And at the moment, during the summer, I hope that I will prepare a training package for them, what to say and how to say. And we want to use the electronic devices about the telemedicine. And I hope that next year we'll have start of our project about precise and timely diagnosis, and they will have easy access to the patient, to the hospitals, and these are our milestones. And these are the tactics that we try to do. It is a green line electronic platform that will elaborate our telemedicine consultation with doctors that are living in other countries and have more experience and working in reference centers, and somebody who can help us to support traveling. Thank you so much.